It's raining outside and I was not getting any ideas for my Sunday tutorials. So I thought, why not make a rain effect tutorial? And so here you go. We'll be making this cool raining scenery with all the animation you can see too. So let's get started. And don't forget to break the like button and smash up the subscribe button for more such next level scratch and code art videos. So we have a sprite in the backdrop ready. We have a character called Frank as the sprite and a dark cloudy like colored background. As always, we start with choosing to paint the sprite. Now we are going to make the frames for the animation which plays when a raindrop falls on something. This is totally your decision how you are going to make it. I might not be a good animator, but if you want to wrap up along exactly what I do, here you go, as I have done it. Coming to the coding part, the coding is really simple. First, you can adjust your direction of falling raindrops. By the way, if you are wondering why have I created the raindrop animation frames facing right, that's because the default direction is 90, which means right. So later in the video, when we move the drops, it actually moves in the direction we have chose. Okay, now, when the green flag is clicked, hide as always. Now, I'm using a broadcast for starting the rain effect if you don't want the rain effect to start instantly when you start the project. Now, we'll take a forever loop and set its X position anywhere between left of the screen and the right of the screen and Y position to the extreme top. Now, the problem we'll be having while setting it to such a height is that it will be stuck at the edge and won't actually get exactly there. Now, the thing I'm doing now with the size blocks will help it to be anywhere out of the edge. Now, I want to clone it every time it spawns to a random location. Now, when a clone is created, until its Y position is less than minus 165, I'll move it at its direction by 20. Now, when it is fulfilled, we play its drop animation by changing it the number of times it needs to reach the second last costume. And then we delete it. Now, so that it also splashes when it hits Frank, we'll add a touching Frank sensing block with the Y pause less than minus 165 condition with an OR operator. Oh, we also need to set our direction to default when the effect starts. As you might have noticed, the raindrops are crawling by the edges as they are getting stuck there, which isn't really cool. So we'll apply the same hack which we had done at the first when spawning our drops random start position to the move 20 block. The water drops look too thick when splashing, so we'll shorten their width from the costume step. For now, we'll let the clones be at the back when they are created, as they look clumsy when carefully seen. For the ground where the drop falls, we'll design another sprite and then make it go to the back. Here, replace the white box condition in the or operator of the rain effect sprite with touching sprite 1. For this, it splashes on the ground 2. Now you can see that the splash animation is a little long, which doesn't really look like water splash. So for that, we'll shorten the frames by deleting of some of them. I realized that the clones which never touched the ground and went off the stage didn't get deleted, and hence the clone limit gets over. So we'll add another OR operator with that OR operator already there and add that Y position less than minus 160 block again. Water droplets are translucent, so we'll add a ghost effect to 60 block whenever a drop is created. And here we have our super pleasing rain effects ready. Don't forget to smash the like and subscribe button. Bye bye.